Dear students, welcome to the EPG Pathshala. I am Dr. Gurmeet Singh, professor in University of Delhi. Today, we are going to discuss about the module Instrumentation of Secondary Ion Mass Spectroscopy under the paper of Surface Analytical Technique 2. As I had said earlier, this is a very important surface analytical technique, which is abbreviated as SIMS. SIMS. After having gained enough knowledge to what exactly this SIMS is about, we moved on to the instrumentation of SIMS. As we all know, this analytical technique involves a surface phenomenon and it studies the composition of the sample. But here the question arises as to how this particular thing can be done. What is the instrumentation that is involved in this and how can we go about it? What are the components of the instrumentation? How do these components function? What are the types of materials that can be analyzed? And what more can we do with this? These are the questions that must be arising in your minds and you must be looking for the answers. The answers to all these questions, which you might have got, can be very clearly answered in the upcoming slides. So here we start. The topic that will be covered in this particular module, we'll be dealing with instrumentation. Then we have primary ion source 1, primary ion source 2, and primary ion source 3. Primary ion column will also be there, which will also have a vacuum. Then mass analyzer. After that, we'll have sector field. And lastly, and a very important part, which deals with time of flight. Next to that, we shall come to quadrupole, then we shall have detector, followed by Faraday cup, then secondary electron multiplier, and finally micro channel plate detector. These are the parts in instrumentation which we shall be discussing, which will have main components of the spectrometer. You will be thinking about what is a spectrometer. A spectrometer is an apparatus or an instrument that is normally used for recording and measuring spectra, especially in a method of analysis. A secondary ion mass spectrometer consists of the following parts. First is ion source, then we have primary ion column. Basically, it helps in accelerating and focusing the beam. Thirdly, we come to higher vacuum sample chamber. This chamber holds the sample and secondary ion extraction lens. Fourth would be mass analyzer. It separates the ions according to their mass to charge ratio. And finally, we have detector, which detects every particle. Here, we are going to talk about instrumentation, which is needed in secondary ion mass spectroscopy. In any form of spectroscopy, the most important part is the one which deals with instrumentation. When we look at the instrumentation for SIMS, there are three main components. The first is ion source. Second will deal with mass analyzer. And the third is going to be talking about detector. So there are going to be three parts. First, ion source. Second, mass analyzer, and third, detector. We'll describe what is ion source, or we call it primary ion source. Here, primary ion source is ions of gaseous elements with electron impact ionization. Deoplasmatron, as we call this, these are argon plus, oxygen plus and oxygen minus, or O negative as we put it. Second is primary ion source. This is primary ion source 2. Ion sources with surface ionization, cesium plus ion sources. Third is primary ion source 3. Ion sources with field emission, which is gallium positive or gallium plus. This is called liquid metal ion sources. Primary ion source and the details are given. Primary ion source 1, as we call this as duoplasmatron. The device was invented by Manfred von Ardenne. Second, it is a source of an ion in which a cathode filament emits electrons into a vacuum chamber. The gas that is used here is argon. This is an inert gas and it is used in very small quantities. This is fed into the gas chamber. This interaction with the free electron from the cathode, the argon is ionized, resulting in the formation of plasma, which is among the fourth fundamental states of matter. The plasma formed is stimulated through a series of at least two highly charged grids and finally becomes an ion beam which moves at a very high speed. The figure of the duoplasmatron is shown in the slide. The diagram or flowchart of primary ion source 1, which we called it as duoplasmatron. The various components or parts have been labeled and can be seen very conveniently in this slide. They basically are gas supply chamber where inert gas is fed. There are two electrodes, cathode and anode, as usual. Ion beam is just opposite to the gas supply. Since large amount of energy is required, there is a coolant also. All the processes take place under the influence of magnetic field. We'll deal with primary ion source 2, as we call it, ion source with surface ionization. This is mainly of cesium plus ion source. In this, beams are generated by surface ionization process. Cesium vapor is produced by heating of a solid cesium compound. The cesium vapor thus produced moves along the drift tube and strikes a tungsten plate where it is thermally ionized. Any atom or molecule moving out from the reservoir is forced to bounce between the tungsten plate and the ionizer tip. This results in most atoms being ionized and escaping through the small hole in the cap. Ion sources with surface ionization, it is cesium plus ion sources. Cesium beams are smaller than those generated by the duoplasmatron and sputter material more effectively due to their greater mass. The cesium gun is very costly to operate and is only used for oxygen, sulfur, or carbon isotopic analysis. Gives the flow diagram of cesium ion source. Here what we have is 10 kVA supply which is there through the cesium vapor, through which the cesium vapor is produced by the heating of a solid cesium compound. Through this drift tube, cesium vapor are passed and further strikes the tungsten plate where they are ionized. Next we have extraction tube. Here heater wires are shown as marked by the red color, and finally an ion beam is moved out. Talks about primary ion source 3, ion source with emission, gallium plus liquid metal. Liquid metal ion source works with metals or metallic alloys which were liquid at room temperature or slightly above. The liquid metal shields a tungsten tip and emits ions under the influence of an intense electric field. Third, it provides a highly focused ion beam less than 50 nanometers with adequate intensity, that is high spatial resolution, which is important for making chemical elements over the specimen's surface. Gives primary ion source 3, ion source with field emission. Here gallium positive liquid metal is the one which is used. The figure gives what way this gallium liquid metal is used here in primary ion source 3. In this field, metal gallium is injected with the help of a capillary under high pressure, and we have extraction electrode for the extraction of metal ions. Primary ion column. It consists of a primary ion beam originating from a primary ion source that helps in accelerating the focusing of the beam into the sample that has to be considered. Then one of the very important things in this is vacuum. The instrumentation is kept under ultra high vacuum. In case of SIMS, the vacuum level is maintained accordingly or accurately and is among the highest of all the instrumentations used in analytical techniques in this class. The presence of vacuum is always kept below a figure of 10 to the power minus 4 or 10 to the power minus 6 torr in order to make sure that the secondary ions being formed do not collide with each other or with the gases that are going to the detector. And by doing this, surface contamination by adsorption of gas particles taking place during this particular measurement is also prevented. In order to get the best results, the above shown mentioned things must be kept in mind. Otherwise, you will not get the proper results. Talks about the second important part of instrumentation, which is mass analyzer. There are three types of mass analyzers. One is sector field, second is quadrupole, and third is time of flight. It must possess the function of mass analyzer is to separate the ions according to their mass to charge ratio. It must possess the following characteristics. It must have high resolution. It must have a high rate of transmission of ions. And there are three types of mass analyzers, as explained earlier also. First is sector field, second is quadrupole, and third is time of flight. Now, having studied the earlier concepts, we shall discuss each type of following fields in brief. First is sector field. It works in combination of magnetic analyzer and electrostatic analyzer. Electrostatic analyzer selects the kinetic energy of the ions, and mass analyzer selects the mass to charge ratio accordingly. Degree of deflection of ions by the magnetic field depends on mass to charge ratio. Its high electron energy or extraction energy, as we call it, results in surface roughness and charging. Second most important concept here is time of flight, which is abbreviated as TOF. It is based on the phenomenon that ions having same energy but different masses travel with different velocities. In TOF, mass to charge ratio of ions is determined by measuring time. With the help of a known strength, ions are accelerated by an electrical field. Ions velocity safely depends on the mass to charge ratio, and the time by the ions to reach a detector at a distance is measured. The advantages of time of flights are theoretically unlimited mass range, moderate to high resolving power, moderate cost, relatively high duty cycle, and the instrumentation is not very complicated. Time of flight, TOF, as we
put it in abbreviated form. Here, iron source with a pulse at 90 degree deflector. Then we have liquid iron source, then target, and then single stage reflector. And a detector, of course. The different parts along the slide, which have been given, are shown in diagram. So we have iron source with a pulse 90 degree deflector, liquid metal iron source, target, single stage reflector, and a detector.
Fundamental principles of time of flight secondary ion mass spectrometry. Time of flight, or TOF SIMS, uses a focused pulse particle beam, typically cesium or gallium, to disclose chemical species on a material surface. Particles produced closer to the site of the impact tend to be dissociated ions, that is positive or negative. Secondary particles generated further from the impact site tends to be molecular compounds, typically fragments of much larger organic macromolecules. The particles are then accelerated into a flight path on their way towards a detector. Because it is possible to measure the time of flight of the particles from the time of impact to detector on a scale of nanoseconds, it is possible to produce a mass resolution as fine as 0.00 times atomic mass unit, that is, one part in a thousand of the mass of a proton. Under typical operating conditions, the result of TOF SIMS analysis include a mass spectrum that surveys all atomic masses over a range of 0 to 10,000 AMU. The rastered beam produces map of any masses of interest on a submicron scale, and depth profiles are produced by removal of surface layers by sputtering under the ion beam. TOF SIMS is also referred to as static SIMS because a low primary ion current is used to tickle the sample surface to liberate ions. Molecules and molecular clusters for analysis. In contrast, dynamic SIMS is the method of choice for quantitative analysis because a high primary ion current results in a faster sputtering rate and produces a much higher ion yield. Thus, dynamic SIMS creates better counting statics for trace elements. The strength and limitations of TOF SIMS. So first we will talk of the strengths point wise. It surveys all masses on material surfaces. These may include single ion, positive or negative, individual isotopes and molecular compounds. Elemental and chemical mapping on a submicron scale is possible. High mass resolution to distinguish species of similar nominal mass, that is, mass resolution is at least 0.00 times AMU. High sensitivity for trace elements or compounds, on the order of ppm to ppb for most species, is possible. Surface analysis of insulating and conducting samples can be done. Depth profiling, that is, in the near surface environment, on the order of individual atomic layers to 10 seconds of nanometers. It is a non-destructive analysis technique. Retrospective analysis for post-data acquisition analysis and interpretation of stored images and spectra. Now, we will talk about the limitations. These are, this technique generally does not produce quantitative analysis, that is, semi-quantitative at best. Optical capabilities are typically limited, making it difficult to find grains or specific regions of interest for analysis. Charging may be a problem in some samples, although charge compensation routines are generally sufficient to overcome these problems. There is commonly an image shift when changing from positive to negative ion data collection mode. This makes it difficult to collect positive and negative ion data on exactly the same spot and the too much data. The benefit of retrospective analysis is also its curse. Every pixel of an image produced by TOF SIMS also contains a full mass spectrum for that point. Thus, it may take hours, days or weeks to fully analyze a single data set. Consequently, it is extremely important to have a very clear purpose in collecting TOF SIMS data and focuses on analyzing and interpreting the data that are specifically related to the question at hand.
Quadrupole. It is also known as quadrupole mass spectrometer, transmission quadrupole mass spectrometer, or quadrupole mass filter. As the name suggests, quadrupole, it contains four cylindrical rods that are aligned parallel with each other. This quadrupole is one of the essential components of the mass spectrometer as it is used for filtering sample ions which depend on their mass to charge ratio. The other important parts related to four metal rods. Since all the four metal rods are set parallel, each rod is banded together electrically and radio frequency voltage is applied between one pair of rod and the other pair along with DC offset voltage. Ions pertaining to certain mass to charge ratio will have unstable directions, movement, and will collide with the rods. This will help in the selection of an ion having appropriate mass to charge ratio by progressively changing the applied voltage. Quadrupoles are extensively used in gas chromatography, mass spectrometry, liquid chromatography, or mass spectrometry as they are used as high relevant detectors. They are also used in cases of study of an individual ion as they can fix themselves in a particular ion for longer period of time. Then talks about the third important component in addition to the earlier two explained. This deals with detector. The detector consists of three parts: Faraday cup, secondary electron multiplier, and micro channel plate. The first one is Faraday cup. It is used to detect the charged particle in vacuum. It is made up of conducting metal cup. It is based on the principle that when the ions strike the metal surface, ions get neutralized while they attain a net charge. The charged metal can further be discharged in order to measure a current which is equivalent to the influenced ions or the number of charges that are carried by the ions in the vacuum can be easily obtained.
Second part of the detector is secondary electron multiplier. It's a tube which has vacuum that enhances the incident charges. In this, a secondary electron which strikes on secondary emission material brings about emission of about 1 to 3 electrons. As soon as the electric potential is applied between the metal plate and the electron gas excited and move to the next metal plate, this obviously will induce secondary emission. It results in a pulse of approximately 108 electrons and it gets combined with a fluorescent screen and the signal which results are obviously generated and are recorded in a fluorescent detector.
Explains the secondary electron multiplier. Here there is an ion beam, there is a detector slit. The electrons are discrete dianode electron multiplier. Then they are reflected and go over to successively higher voltage plates. And this way, they keep on multiplying from 1 to 2 to 3, 4, 5, etc. and then go to the amplifier stage. Talks about microchannel plate detector. In microchannel plate detector, it is similar to secondary electron multiplier, as both of them enhances photons by the amplification of electron by secondary emission. But microchannel plate detector has separate channels and it provides spatial resolution. Dimensions of microchannel plate are as follows: 10 micrometers in diameter and 400 micrometers long, 7 degrees from the perpendicular to the surface plate, located at 12 micrometer pitch. Goes on to explain further this particular part. The electron pulse from the back of the detector is passed to another microchannel plate and is directed with a speed towards a phosphor screen. Here, of course, it is detected. An ion which is passing down the channel hits the channel wall and produces a secondary electron. And these secondary electrons trigger an electron shower down the channel. This has been indicated in this slide also.
Now, moving further, we will talk about multi-collection detectors. As an example of NanoSIMS collection detector setup in this, the multi-collection capability allows up to 7 masses to be detected simultaneously, yet there is a physical limitation to how close the trolleys can be positioned, which is dependent on the mass range. For the standard NanoSIMS 50, it has 5 detectors. One mass unit separation is only possible up to mass 58, allowing the simultaneous detection of all the isotopes of iron. The NanoSIMS, as with conventional single detector SIMS instrument, also has the ability to switch the magnetic field during analysis to measure more masses. Multi-collection allows and to allow one mass unit spacing where the physical separation is not possible. It is also possible to combine the multi-collection capability with magnetic field, switching to cycle between 2B field settings while using more than one detector. Of course, cycling the B field adds significantly to the time taken for an analysis. In multi-collection mode, the B field is regulated with a nuclear magnetic resonance NMR probe to ensure the peak does not drift over time. The NanoSIMS 50 is equipped with EM and FC type of detectors. EM detectors have a fast response time and are thus used for imaging, yet are susceptible to a number of intrinsic artifacts, including dead time, aging, and quasi-simultaneous arrivals, QSA.
Let's summarize the facts that we have learned in this module. A secondary ion mass spectrometer consists of ion source, primary ion column, high vacuum sample chamber, mass analyzer, and a detector. Primary ion source here are of three types. Duoplasmatron is a source of ion in which a cathode filament emits electrons into a vacuum chamber. In primary ion source 2, ion source with a surface ionization combined with cesium ion source, they generate a beam by surface ionization process, and cesium vapor is produced by heating of a solid cesium compound. In primary ion source 3, ion source with field emission, gallium liquid metal along with liquid metal ion source works with a metal or metallic alloy which are liquid at room temperature or slightly above the room temperature, round about that. It consists of a primary ion beam originating from a primary ion source that helps in accelerating and focusing the beam into the sample that has to be considered for analysis, of course. There are three types of mass analyzers which have been explained above in the earlier part of this module. Thank you very much.